Hey guys, this is Szymon from Ventilate. I want to walk you through how the device looks right now. This is fairly final version of how we want to put it together. And I'll run you through all the components and more or less I'll run you through how it works. So, as you see, we have the device. The device requires some electrical power. There are various ways where you can how you can deal with that. So, we have our power supply, what we use right now. You could also use a battery. This is small motorcycle battery. So right now we work on 12 volts up to more or less 24. So you just have to put something. Well, the device is also connected to source of oxygen. We are working in the same time and we're going to concentrate on that soon to build oxygen concentrators. Now you have to have your oxygen bottle connected to the device. Then, well, that's about it. The only remaining thing is that you might want to see what's happening with your patient. Surprisingly, putting some decent screen on a device would increase the price twice. So there are various ways how you can do it with our device. What we put here is a computer screen so that you can see it large, but you could also take a smartphone or some other ways which we're going to describe in the paper later on. And what else? Well, you have your filters so that you don't contaminate stuff. You have your standard medical hose. You have your pressure sensing hoses. And then, well, you have your dummy lungs just supported with some mass to show how it's going to move. Now we are in the idle mode. I just want to show you two basic modes of operation. One of them, according to some doctors, is the default mode for what you want to have with your COVID patients. And another one is considered to be slightly sophisticated. And then doctors vary on opinion whether it would be bringing more or less benefit than the other one. So the first mode is called continuous positive airway pressure. Let me just switch it to the different mode. And yeah, that's what we have. So the device just keeps on the constant pressure. If we would put some pressure on, being like an exhale of the patient, it will top it up. You can see on the plot that it tries to stay in the constant with responses to how the chest moves. So now I'm gonna show you a second mode out of three basic modes of operation we're gonna have, which is called BPAP. This is gonna be a BPAP which doesn't sense the patient because we don't have a patient here. This is going to be the BPAP that just executes the orders from the time machine, so from the clock. Let me just put the dial in the right position. So as you can see, the lungs are opening and then closing accordingly. You can see on the plots the pressure and flow. So you see for the brief moment, the pressure gets higher up to plus 15. This is about the maximum what you would be putting to non-invasive treatment. Usually with COVID patients, doctor opts to smaller values, but this looks good when it moves a lot. And then you have another pressure which is sustained for the exhale. You could be choosing to breathe with lower or higher pressures. You're gonna see me now just changing pressure to high pressure to lower values. The book's gonna be moving a little bit less, as you see. We could also change the lower pressure to even lower values. And that's about what you wanna be achieving with your patients. As I said, with most doctors, you could hear that you wanna work only on the continuous mode so that your patient is breathing and you just keep on the pressure on his face, on his mask or on his cap or whatever you try to use to give him a non-invasive ventilation. And that's about it. That's how it works. I think I didn't mention the oxygen clearly enough. You have to keep in mind that with COVID patients, with those non-invasive ventilations, you need to have your oxygen. I know that in some countries they are running out of the oxygen, of medical oxygen right now. We are trying to do our best on trying to cover that as well in Ventilate. But right now the device requires you to have a bottle. You connect your bottle, you choose the right amount of oxygen to flow, and then, well, you have it. We are able to put about 70% at a maximum of oxygen to our patient reliably. But obviously you can choose also lower values. Doctors are saying most often about something like 40%. And then I'm referring to doctors here and there in the video. So guys, please remember, this is not a toy. So yeah, we try to build the hopes for everybody on how this is going to be used. But what you need in order to use this device properly is a medically trained person to help you in order to choose the right set of parameters in order to observe the person. We are also working very hard on providing as smooth and as easy to use interfaces to help those medical people that will be helping the patients, but you need them, so say some nice words to them. And well, let's just keep the hopes high. I mean, the spring is coming around here. Let's try to be a little bit more cheery and not so gloomy. We are almost there to give you some extra tools to work on boots on the ground with the disease. Stay safe.